Amen. I still cling to the old rugged cross.
Oh. Happy birthday.
Now, why are y'all laughing? The question is, why did I spill that water? Somebody bumped into me, shook me, didn't they? Yeah, might say that. You know why I spilled that water? I spilled that water because there's water in this cup. Some of you ain't woke up yet. I spilled that water because there is water in this cup. If I had Dr. Pepper in this cup, I'd have spilled Dr. Pepper. If I had coffee in this cup, I'd have spilled coffee. But thank God it was water. Thank God it was water. There's water in this cup. So whatever's in the cup will come out when you're shaken. When you're shaken. So today, what's in your cup? What's in your cup? I'm asking you, what's in your cup? And don't answer it out loud. What's in your cup? What's in your life? Because the Bible tells us in Luke 6:45 this morning, Jesus speaking, he said, a good man out of the good treasures of his heart bringeth forth that which is good, and an evil man out of that of the evil treasure of his heart bringeth forth that which is evil. So what was in the cup? If it's good in the cup, the good will come out. If there's evil in the cup, the evil will come out. For out of the abundance of the heart, he said, his mouth speaketh. So think about that. What's in your cup? Because there was water in this cup, water came out. What's in your heart comes out of the mouth. What's in your heart comes out of the mouth, whether it's good or evil. So what's in your cup? What's in your cup? Jesus tells us in this word that we could tell a tree by the fruit that it bears, meaning that he wasn't speaking of a tree that we see out in the yard, because I have trouble identifying some of those trees, you know, out in the yard. Anybody with me? Sometimes I can't tell one tree from another. I know some of you, you're tree huggers, you know all the trees, and you can tell me there's a maple tree, that's an oak tree, and that's a cherry tree, and I can tell a fruit tree when it bears fruit. You know, I can tell, when I moved into my house that I'm in now, we had some trees out in the yard, and I knew some of the oak tree. I at least got that much sense. I know an oak tree. And I can tell that, but we had some of these little small trees. And I can identify some dogwood trees. I'm not completely dumb on the trees, you know. I can identify some trees, but I can't identify all trees. So there was one little tree in the yard that I couldn't identify. You know, I knew it was a small tree. That's all I knew, that it was a small tree. And it wasn't a dogwood tree. I knew a dogwood tree. But this tree, I didn't know what it was until it bared fruit, and it was an apple tree. I don't expect that apple tree to produce bananas, hello? It's not going to grow coconuts. It's not that type of tree. But Jesus said we could tell a tree by the fruit that it bears. That you can tell who a person is by the fruit they bear in their life. Because what's in the cup will come out. Some of you got this one, amen. What's in the cup will come out. Now, sometimes people will try to trick us. I know y'all ain't never done that. Some people put on a good facade. They got a good outward appearance, but the inside of the cup is quite different from the outer cup. Hello, you know what I'm talking about here? It's like we're talking about those trees. It's like a Christmas tree. Some people are like a Christmas tree. I ain't never seen a Christmas tree, you know. You say, well, you ain't never seen a Christmas tree? You never have Christmas? There ain't a Christmas tree in the forest. It's a cedar tree or, you know, a pine tree or something of that sort. And we make it a Christmas tree because we're going to put on a front. Hello? That tree is still the same God created it, either a cedar or a pine or I don't know. I don't know what you use. But it's still, if you use a real tree, it's a cedar or what? What's the other one? Spruce? Y'all use it. But we'll decorate that thing. We might put apples on it, but it don't make it an apple tree. Right? Come on, y'all gonna help me preach today. You can put apples on it, but it won't make it an apple tree. You can put popcorn on it. It ain't gonna be a popcorn tree. Y'all remember doing that? We put on a good front. But Jesus said, out of the abundance of the heart, the man speaketh. It may look good on the outside, but the inside ain't nothing happening. It's like that old missionary, amen, he came back from overseas and he said, I was traveling, you know, back from Mexico, and he said, I come across the border, and he said, I've been driving all day, and he said, I was hungry because preachers love to eat, amen, I told you that. He said, I was hungry, and I was driving down that interstate, and he said, I looked over on the side of the road over there, it was a big old chef up on top of the building there, amen, and he had a bell in his hand, and he said, when the bell is ringing, something good is cooking on the inside. He said, I saw that neon light up. He said, I whipped off the interstate on the exit rim and whipped down in the parking lot where this restaurant was. He said, I parked it in and went inside expecting to have a great meal, amen, and feel my hunger, amen. And he said, I went inside and won't nobody in there. He said, I sat at the table and I waited and I waited and I heard people in the back talking, and he says, you know, I waited and finally, he said, I called a fellow, and when he came out and I said, sir, excuse me, sir, I want to get my order. He said, sir, we ain't even open. He said, well, the neon light lit up outside. He says, when the bell is ringing, something good is cooking on the inside. He said, well, ain't nothing cooking in here. We ain't even open yet. Ain't that just like many of us? Oh, we giving a good front on the outside. Ain't nothing happening on the inside. God is 40 miles away from us. We're telling folks, hey, man, we're a good Christian. We'll do this, we'll do that, and we all about this and all about that. But ain't nothing happening on the inside, because ain't nothing in our cup. Ain't nothing in our cup. So what's in your cup? What fruit are you bearing? When life gets tough, what spills over when life gets tough? Does joy, gratefulness, peace, and humility come out of your cup when you are shaking? Or does anger and bitterness and harsh words and action come out of your cup when you're shaking? Because what's in your cup will come out. What's in your cup will come out. When things need to be done, do you do it with a heart of thanksgiving? Or do you do it mumbling, complaining, and griping about it? What's in your cup will come out. Oh, Lord, I got to go to church again this morning. Friend, that's not a grateful heart. It should be an honor and privilege for us to come to the house of God, and I thank you for coming. You saw that need. Amen. What's in your cup came out this morning. But there are many to this morning who stood back. Amen. Because, see, Sunday, I shared this with our choir and I shared it with my wife. And what God gave me this morning is the fact that on Sunday, the devil likes to use that to tell us to go ahead and sleep in. But it always is amazing to me that people, amen, they get up early every other day. Matter of fact, I mean, I get up early too. And I get on Facebook and I share a daily thought sometimes. I see people on there, you know, because my little green lights light up, you know, when you're on there. Y'all know what I'm talking about? I don't know all about that, but I at least know when somebody's on there. Yeah. Yeah, the little green lights lights up in there. And they're on there early in the morning. But when it comes to Sunday, you don't see that little green light light up. And you don't see them in the house of God. Why, the devil has told me, you know, you need to sleep in today. And you know, we can get up early any other time but Sunday. We can make our way to a lot of other events and a lot of other things in this world. But when it comes to church, if we wake up late, we won't go in late. We'll just say, I ain't going today. What's in your cup will come out. What's important to you? I love the Lord. Amen. He's important to me. If I woke up late, I'll be here late. I'll make it to the house of God. I'll make it to the house of God. And that's the way we should be if we're children of God. No matter what, we'll make it. Amen. Because it's important to worship God, to serve Him, to give of our time, talent, and treasure, and testimony, and to encourage one another in prayer. It's important because what's in your cup will come out. What's in your cup will come out. So you ought to do things with a grateful heart if God's in your cup. And if God ain't in your cup, evil's going to come out, and you're going to be angry, and you're going to be bitter, and you're going to say harsh words, and sometimes you're going to hurt not only yourself but others around you. It's easy to fake what's in your cup or your heart until you're shaken to the core. When you're shaken to the core, amen, that's when the test really begins. That's when the test really begins. In the book of Acts, in chapter 9, in verses 36 through 42, we read of a little place near Joppa where this lady named Tabitha, better known as Dorcas, lived. Now, Dorcas was a lady who was a disciple. And you might say, well, I thought that Jesus only had men for disciples. But a disciple, friend, is a learned one. It could be men or women. A learned one. Somebody who has studied, amen, and know what God says and what God requires them to do. Well, she was such a lady that, I mean, she loved the Lord and she loved others, because the Bible tells us if we love God with all our heart, soul, and mind, and body, that's the first and great commandment. And the second is likened to it, that we love one another even as ourselves. Dorcas was a lady not only in love with God, but she was in love with her neighbors and friends, and she had a heart of giving. That was in her cup, amen. She had a heart of giving. Given of her time and her talent and her treasures. She could make clothes for the widows. She would make clothes and give it to the widow ladies in her community. She looked after those. She might even gave a meal every now and then. But she learned that. Amen. She was a disciple because she had learned what God expected her to do and filled her cup, amen, with the capability of doing that thing that God had called her to do. I'm glory to God. I like that. Amen. God will fill your cup, amen, and give you a mission, amen, if you just learn and learn how to, amen, be attentive to what He's calling you to do. So she gave. But all of a sudden, she died. Peter gets wind of this. And Peter comes and Peter, amen, now is going to give back to her, amen, what she'd been given to others, because, amen, he had something different in his cup that God has called him to do. God has called him to be a minister, amen, of the gospel. And God has called him to share that good news with all those in his surroundings. And so Peter, amen, comes to the scene. And Peter, amen, hears that she had passed away. And he went to where she was. And he sat there and he prayed. And all of a sudden, life came back to Dorcas. She sat up and she recognized Peter. And Peter told her to get up. And she did. Did Peter have something special? Nothing but the Lord Jesus in his heart. You remember Peter, amen? His cup was, amen, wasn't wasn't filled, amen, to the brim so he could spill over like he is right here in the beginning. You remember his cup, amen, had a facade on it for a while until God got a hold of him and said, Peter, do you really love me? Do you really love me, Peter? And if you really love me, you'll fill your cup with my presence. And if you fill my cup with my presence, amen, it can spill over into others because I am the resurrection and the life. And he that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. Do you love me, Peter? And Peter said, Lord, I love you. And God began to fill his cup. And so now his cup is spilling over, amen, with the word of life to Dorcas. And she raised up from the dead. Whoo, what power. What power. So what do you want in your cup? I want some of that power. Amen. I want some of that resurrection life in my cup. Oh, it's better than Folgers in your cup. Amen. Yeah, it's better than that. Amen. It's better than anything this world has to offer. If you want to change what's in our cup, if we want to change what's in our cup, we need to spend time as the disciples of old did with God. Peter couldn't do that unless he spent time with God. And God is willing to spend time with you if you're willing to spend time with him. Because God knows the true intent of the heart. And if you have a desire to learn more about God, then God, amen, is going to give you more about him. Whether it's in your study or in the sermons that you hear or in the music that you hear sing from the gospel. He's going to, amen, give you more of him if you so desire more of him. I want to learn more about him. He's an awesome God. He's an awesome God. He can do things man cannot do. Man cannot do. We limit, amen, ourselves because of our little infinite mind that we don't understand everything. But God, amen, he has no limitations. And the more you learn about him, the more you can do through him. I said, the more you can do through him. More you can do through him. The power of prayer. The power of prayer is noted in his word. Pray without ceasing, he said in Luke 18:1. Pray without ceasing. And if you pray without ceasing, he said, you won't quit. The problem is we quit before our cup gets filled.
Guilty.
We quit before our cup gets filled. And David said this. He said, the Lord, when you learn, amen, that he's your shepherd and he is all that you need. Y'all know what I'm talking about? 23rd Psalm, he said, the Lord is my shepherd and I shall not want. He's all I need. I don't want anything else. Because I learn who fills my cup. Glory to God. I learn, amen, amen, it's more important, amen, to let him fill my cup. So when my cup is filled, it'll run over. He said, surely, he said, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy will follow me all the days of my life. And I shall dwell in my house of the Lord forever. Because, say, when you bumped into, when Cheryl bumped into me, where did that water go? On me. It was in the cup, but it spilled over on me. If God is in our cup and he has filled it to the brim, amen, when we bump into somebody, he'll spill over on them. Y'all getting the picture this morning? He'll spill over on them. Oh boy, if I had to walk through this life, amen, I want Jesus to rub off on somebody. I want Jesus, amen, to spill over on somebody. Say that with me, amen. If you believe that in your heart, you want your cup filled and run it over that it spills on somebody, say, I want Jesus to spill over on somebody. Somebody, amen. Somebody. So if we want our cup, amen, to be filled and want it to change, we need to spend time with God. Of course, Dorcas spent time with God. To learn, amen, how to spill over her love of gratitude and appreciation for her neighbor. Peter had to spend time with God to be able for his cup to spill over life to Dorcas and others with the good news of the gospel. And if we want to change what's in our cup, we should show love toward one another. And finally, friend, today, amen. If we want our cup to change what's in our cup, we need to use our talents, our treasure, our testimony, and all that we have for the glory of God. Some of you got great talent. You can use it. Dorcas' talent was she could make clothes. She used that to be able to provide clothing for those widow ladies and those in her community that were in need. She had a talent. Everybody in here got at least one that God has given you. You're good at something. Some of you say, I ain't good at nothing. Oh, yes, you are. You're good at something. Some of you are very good talkers. You're better talkers than I am. Yeah. And some of you, I mean, you got a gift. I mean, you can call and check on your neighbor. You have that gift, that talent. Hello, neighbor. It's me again. We can check on our neighbor. We got different talents. Some of us are good carpenters. Some of us are good mechanics. Some of us are good at different other things. Some of us are good at cooking, you know. We could cook a meal for somebody that may be in need. Some of us are good at smiling. Look at you, see. You know, a smile will bring a smile to somebody else's face. Just look to your neighbor and smile at him. I guarantee you they'll smile back at you. Look, I tell you what, I tell you old Wilbur right there, I don't know what Dorothy just said to him, but he sure did grin up a storm there, you know. He grinned up a storm. I mean, yeah, we have a talent that God has given us. And we need to use it. We need to use it for the glory of God. Because what's in your cup will come out, right? Amen. What's in your cup? And we can't sit back and not do nothing. Because we need to have our cup filled with something. All right? Listen to this in closing. This is a story about four people. And the name is everybody, somebody, anybody, and nobody. Okay? Four people. Everybody, somebody, anybody, nobody. That was an important job to be done. And everybody was sure that somebody would do it. Anybody could have done it, but nobody did it. Somebody got angry about that because it was everybody's job. Everybody thought anybody could do it, but nobody realized that everybody wouldn't do it. It ended up that everybody blamed somebody when nobody did what anybody could do. Some of you will get it later. But my friend, today, what's in your cup? Because everybody has a cup. We just need somebody who's called Jesus Christ to fill it. Hello? And when it's filled to the brim, anybody and everybody can spill it. It should be easy for people to look at our lives and see the difference between a Christian and a lost person. Think back over the past week. Have you had an opportunity to be generous and to share with someone about what's in your cup? Because as believers, we're supposed to every day be filling this cup up so that when we are shaken by something during our daily routine,
it'll spill over on somebody else. Is Jesus in your cup? Let us stand.